Welcome to English Literature class, my dear students of class 11th. You know that Act 2, Scene 1 is going on, and here we are at line number 135, the speech of Alonso. Alonso says, "So is the dearest over the laws." So, Alonso says, because of this fault, I have suffered the heaviest loss. Because of this fault, I have suffered the heaviest loss. Means, he lost his son, Ferdinand. Gonzalo says, my lord Sebastian, the truth you speak doth lack some gentleness and time to speak it in. You rub the sore when you should bring the plaster. Very good line, very good dialogue he has given. Gonzalo says, my lord Sebastian, what you speak may be the truth. It is right. It is right what you have spoken. What you speak may be the truth, but it is rather cruel. It is rather cruel. And it is not the time to say, it is not the suitable time, appropriate time to say such a thing. As King Alonso is in great loss, he is suffering from pain, he is in great loss. So you now aggravate. You are just worsening his pain. You are just worsening his pain, then you console him. You are not consoling him by this way. You are just worsening his pain. Sebastian says, very well. That is true. Antonio says, in most chiranjianly, you should act. Antonio says, you should act just like a surgeon to cure the king's wound. You should not say such type of words or sentences for King Alonso. You should act just like a surgeon to cure the king's wound. Gonzalo says, it will foul weather in us all, good sir. It is sad for us all. Gonzalo says, it is sad for us all, sir, when you are sad. As you are sad, we are all feeling very sad. When you are cloudy, when you are sad. Sebastian says, foul weather, does it make you sad? Does it make you sad? Antonio says, very foul, very sad indeed. I am really very sad. I am very really unhappy. Gonzalo says, had I plantation of this isle, my lord? Gonzalo says, had I the right to colonize this island, my lord, he wishes. Antonio says, he had sown with natal seed. Antonio says, he would sow nettles. Nettles mean thorny plants on it. Again, he is started commented. He comments on Gonzalo. Sebastian says, or docks or mallows. Or he would plant roadside weeds here. Gonzalo says, and were the king on it, what would I do? And if I were the king of this island, what would I do? He thinks, Gonzalo says, if I would be the king, then what would I do? He says. Sebastian says, escape being drunk a want of wine. You would abstain from wine. You would abstain from wine to avoid drunkenness. But there is no wine. If you would be the king, you would not allow anybody to drink wine. But by the way, there is no wine on this island. Gonzalo says, in the commonwealth, very important lines here. What does Gonzalo think? If he would be the king of that island, commonwealth, he talks about commonwealth. In the commonwealth, I would by contraries execute all things, for no kind of traffic would I admit, no name of magistrate, letter should not be known, riches, poverty and use of service, none contract, succession, bound of land, till the vineyard, none, no use of metal, corn or wine or oil. No occupation, all men idle, all and women too, but innocent and pure, no sovereignty. He says, in my commonwealth, in secular society of a state, commonwealth means secular society, where each and everyone will be equal. In my commonwealth, I would accomplish all things done contrary, opposite. I will done all things opposite, contrary to the methods now adopted. What methods are being adopted now, I would do just opposite. What? I would allow no trade, no magistrates, there would be no education, no riches or poverty, no cases of men serving others, there would be no agreements, laws of succession, limits, land, boundaries, cultivation or plantation of vines, there would be no use of metals, corn, wine or oil. There would be no labor, all men would be idle, and the women would be innocent and pure. There would be no king to rule the others. These are the things Gonzalo thinks that if he would be the king, he would do. Sebastian says, yet he would be the king on it. Yet he would be the king of it. Antonio says, the latter end of his commonwealth forgets the beginning. Antonio says, in the end of his description of his commonwealth, he forgets what he had said earlier. Then Gonzalo speaks, all things in common nature should produce without sweat or endeavor, treason, felony, sword, pike, knife, gun or need of any engine would I not have, but nature should bring forth of its own kind all vice and all abundance to feed my innocent people. Further he says, what would he do if he would be the king in his commonwealth? In secular society, what would he do? He says, all ordinary process of production should function without fatigue or toil, without any hard work. Treachery or crime, as well as swords, spears, knives or war weapons, I would not have. Nature would bring forth all things in abundance, in plenty, to feed the innocent people. Sebastian says, no marrying among his subjects. Would there be marriages among his subjects? Antonio says, none man, all idle. No, none. They would all be idle. No marriage. Gonzalo says, I would with such perfection go on, sir, to excel the golden age. Gonzalo says, I would rule with such excellence, sir, that it would surpass, it would go beyond the fabled golden age. To surpass the joys and blessings, to excel the golden age means to surpass the joys and blessings. Sebastian says, God save His Majesty, God save the King, long live Gonzalo. Gonzalo says, and do you mark me, sir? Well, are you paying attention to me, sir? Alonso says, Preeti, no more, thou dost talk nothing to me. Please stop, you talk nonsense to me. Don't talk nonsense to me. Gonzalo says, I do well believe your highness, and it is to minister occasion to the gentlemen who are of such sensible and nimble lungs that they always used to laugh at nothing. Gonzalo says, I do believe your highness. I spoke in order to provide to these gentlemen, Antonio and Sebastian, an opportunity to laugh. They have such sensitive lungs that they can laugh at anything. Antonio said, that was you were laughed at. It was you at whom we were laughing. Your foolish activities, your foolish thinking, on your foolish thinking we are laughing at you. Gonzalo says, who in this kind of merry fooling I am nothing to you, so you may continue and laugh at nothing still. Gonzalo says, in this kind of idle talk I cannot compete with you, so you may continue to laugh at nothing. Antonio says, what a blow was there given. Ah, what a master stroke you have achieved by uttering that remark. Sebastian says, and it had not fallen flat long. Yes, if it had not fallen harmlessly. Gonzalo says, you are gentlemen of brave metal. You would lift the moon out of her sphere if she would continue in it 5 weeks without changing. Gonzalo remark, comment. Sebastian says, you are a gentleman of great courage. You can do anything. You would even move the moon to go on for more than a month without her usual change. The moon completes its revolution within a month. But he says, you would even move the moon. To go on for more than a month without her usual change. Here enter aerial invisible playing serious music. And what happens after that you will study in lecture number 4. Thank you, student. Thank you, sir.